Hello everybody and welcome to Pro Evolution Soccer 2020. It's a new series on the channel. We're going to be going into the Master League, and yes, I'm slightly behind everybody else who's got about 10 episodes out by now, if not more. But I was away on a work business trip when Provo was released, so that's why I'm running late with it. So apologies about that. But let's dive straight into it. Into the Master League we go. We'll be creating a new Master League, please, Provo. We will be going with the club team. When I was younger, I always did the Master League original and made it incredibly difficult. And I'd be tempted to do that. Should I do that? Should I do that or should I go for the club one? I think we don't. Do you know what? Let's have a challenge. I'm going Master League original lineup. We're going to go into the Skybet Championship, obviously. So it's always automatically going to be very difficult. And I'm thinking, I don't know who to be, really. We could be someone like Wigan, you know, had hard times recently. Stoke recently relegated. Sheffield Wednesday, Reading, Nottingham Forest, a bit of Luton, Leeds, dirty, dirty Leeds, Hull. I should have thought this through, really. I've always liked Fulham, but I don't think I want to take Fulham. Maybe Charlton. Someone like Charlton or Bristol City. I used to live in Bristol. I used to live in Birmingham, and I was Aston Villa in the last save as well. I was like, yeah, I don't know. I mean, Blackburn have been on hard times recently. They've got a nice kit. Maybe Bristol. Maybe Bristol City. I mean, you know, it's Master League, isn't it? So if you're not enjoying it, you can get a job offer and move somewhere else. So I've just realised their badge hasn't come into the game, Hull Cities. Oh, I'll have to look into that. Apologies about that one. So it won't be Hull. That'll roll Hull out. Definitely. Maybe. Who should we be? Who do we want to take? Should we take Wigan? Try and take Wigan back to the top. Yeah, let's go with Wigan. Let's be with Wigan. Choose your appearance. Okay. I mean, is there any? Yeah, okay. They do have some generic faces. It could be Rude Hullet. Rude Hullet getting the, or Lotham. Roberto Carlos getting the job in charge. Do you know what? I quite like that idea. Roberto Carlos is going to get the management job. Yeah, Roberto Carlos, Brazil. He wears a suit. I mean, what else could he wear? I think he's more of a shirt sort of guy. Nah, that sportswear doesn't suit him. Suit or shirt? Suit or shirt? I think he's a shirt sort of guy, Roberto Carlos. So Roberto Carlos is going to be named manager of Wigan Athletic in the championship. We'll have normal, starting budget, normal for, yep. Salary display, probably go weekly because it's a bit more realistic. Match level, top player, match time, 10 minutes. Currency, we will be in the Great British Pounds. And stops doing the transfer only when there is progress. Thank you very much. So, I'm very excited to be playing Pro Evo. I've played a few games, but that was only to test out everything we've got. And here we are in the Wigan Athletic. I assume corridor and training facility, as Roberto Carlos is getting a talking to from who I can only assume is the chairman. This must be a couple of our players. Excellent. Now, sorry if you're expecting a Man United Master League, and if this doesn't get much traction, we can, you know, knock it on the head and go and be Man United or a team in the Premier League or Juventus or something like that. But here we are. So Roberto Carlos having a nice little sit down with a cup of coffee, chatting to his new team all around. Some more teammates, I think. Some more players coming. Look, now, for those that don't know, the Master League original lineup that you get, all the players are terrible. And you generally have one standout player who all the other clubs tried to sign. So there's going to be a lot of training like this with Mr. Roberto Carlos. He'll be teaching them how to hit a left-footed free kick. I'm sure there'll be plenty of that in training. So season objectives, setting the goals. Let's see what we do. Now I'm hoping they just say like avoid relegation, which is fine, because if you finish bottom you still don't get relegated, which is fine. So Roberto Carlos, I'd like to discuss. If we want to be aiming higher next season, well, then we need to take at least the 8th position in the league this year. How does that sound to you? That sounds frankly impossible, because our team is a bunch of nobodies who are going to be absolutely terrible, and we're going to have a really small budget. Well, I don't agree, and I don't think we can finish top half, and I don't think we should finish the league. So I think I agree. We'll aim for 8th, and we'll see how it goes. So Roberto Carlos, it looked like he just had XL in front of him then, which is impressive. Good to see that Roberto Carlos is proficient in the use of Microsoft Office, which is not an ad, by the way. Microsoft aren't sponsoring this, neither is Office. as part of the Microsoft brand. But if they do want to sponsor it, please just get in touch at my email. That settles it then. As long as you're on board, I feel confident that this will work. Now, we've got a balding, sort of old looking, he looks like he's had a really hard life, our chairman. I'm going to assume he's the chairman. Chairman needs a name, let me know down below. We're of the same mind. That's very good to see. Eighth position then, with this ragtag bunch of absolute misfits. And now we've got to meet the press. And I'm about to sneeze. This is all going horrendously wrong at the moment. Okay, so in the end I didn't sneeze, but it's quite dramatic. Congratulations on becoming manager. What's your plan for the team? Are you going to introduce your preferred system straight away or stick with what the team is used to? Now he's pondering that question quite a lot. I've got my own ideas. I want you to say thank you to the chairperson and sports director for believing in me. My first job here is to teach the team my brand of football. If a player finds himself unable to adapt, then he'll be sent packing. Yeah, let's go. Iron fist. I also pretty sure I said not a suit, just a shirt. But Roberto Carlos managing Wigan. If we've got any Wigan fans, then what do you feel about this? It must be a coup. What style of football do you want to play this season? I'm going to say possession-based because it's going to be... I want to see clean sportsmanlike football. I want to put on a show. I want to see the balls play hard. I don't want to put on a show because I don't think we're going to score that many goals. So we also need a name for this guy right above me as well. So we need a name for the chairman and we need a name for him, who I imagine will be the sports director or maybe the press secretary. I want to see the boys play hard, so intensity is the key word for me. Whether you're attacking or defending, you've got to be ready to put your heart and soul into the game. Precision and technique have their place, but it's critical to remember that football is a contact sport. It's a battle out there, and there's no place for players who aren't ready to lay it all on the line and play their hearts out. And that is Roberto Carlos's philosophy of football. I mean, just how he was brought up with Brazil, I imagine, when he won the World Cup with Brazil. But there we go, that's the press conference done. I do quite like the cutscenes. They're new, obviously, to Master League this year. And as is this menu, which is very nice. I mean, it's... Okay, it all looks pretty similar. It's just this season's target. Yeah, we've looked at that. The main schedule for August, okay. Your agent. Okay, yeah, we can get offers. The budget, okay. Right, brilliant. They were rubbish messages. I don't want to forward in time yet. So here we go. I'll show you how bad our players are. So 4-2-3-1 is what they reckon we should be playing at the moment. We have a 68 rated goalkeeper. Our highest rated player is 72, which is Castledine, I think. Castledine, which would be interesting. We have a 67 striker on the bench. A 67 Vrani in the middle. Yeah, okay, this is pretty appalling. This is why it's so much tougher to play like this. I think Camrice, let's push you up into... I don't want to... Roberto Carlos would never play with two holding midfielders, would he? It just wouldn't happen. So I think we're actually going to go for a 4-3-3 to leave us having a bit more of an attacking option. So we've got a left winger there. What are you? You're... Well, striker, you have literally no speed. Do you have speed? Yes, you're very quick. Okay, so you can keep the starting spot at the moment. You're very quick. You're very quick, and your shooting's okay. Shooting's okay. Shooting's pretty poor. Okay, we're going to... Yeah, it's a bit like an attacking sort of 4-3-3, I think, is what we're going to go with. You're a pretty good all-rounder. You're pretty crap at dribbling, as you'd expect. You're just a... I imagine Eriksen is the beast in the air. And Seferet, I think his name is. Seferet, yeah. Okay, so we've got Melikov in goal, Eriksen, Vasil, Seferet, and Goyaza, Hejtech, Rice, Castledine, Pallister, Carlton, and Gios, who is a name I will not be able to pronounce in the midst of battle of this. Right, so first things first, let's go to the... Let's go and have a look and see if we can actually appoint someone. So we're straight into the Skybet Championship and we've got Cardiff up first, recently relegated Cardiff. So that's going to be a bit of tough. So club account balance, we need to check see what we've got. Television rights, it will vary depending on the result in the final position. Okay, so transfer, we've got, obviously got nothing, there's zero in there at the moment. We're playing 51,000. So in terms of fan club income and stuff, it's all pretty good. We should have quite a little money. Budget settings, I think, is what I want. Yeah. Receivers transfer. Pay with salary. Yeah. There we go. Pay with salary. So now every money we earn will be going into our. Oh, look at those animations as well. They're really cool. I really like PES 2020 so far for Master League. They've made a big effort on it, I think. So is it in database? Okay, I'm a bit confused. I just want to go and sign people. Negotiations. I don't know how I missed that. Absolutely rubbish. So this is exactly the same. Okay, this will be easy. So our salary budget, we've got £2,700 per week left to spend. Who have we got in our youth team? Have we got any good players? So Harrington at 69, but his salary would be above what we can pay. We do have Olli Kainen, yeah, I think that's right. We could afford to bring him up as a left winger. Not really playing a left midfielder in this formation, though. Good acceleration. Everything else is pretty poor. Texaria sounds like he'll be amazing. Offensive fullback. Vinaire, I think, do you get their... Oh, you do get their little chart to see where they're going to... Where they're estimated to progress. Okay, there's no one brilliant in there at the moment. And there are actually some absolutely dreadful people in there as well. Let's go and have a look at advanced search. Now... If I remember rightly from this, back in the day, the easiest thing to do was go straight to the loan list and see if you can loan it. Gabriel Jesus is listed for loan. That is absolutely incredible. Right. I don't think we're going to be able to get Gabriel Jesus. Does it still... Yeah, the bar... Oh, hang on. Affection. So, I mean, potentially. I mean, Rude's just come in for a little chat. So, if you hear a bark, it's not... Obviously, it's not me. I'm not a dog. But Rude has just come in. I think he's just going to sit nicely under my desk. I mean, surely we're never going to be able to afford anyone like this. This is absolutely ridiculous. Phil Foden, let's have a look at... Request 1 year loan. Okay, they want us to pay £6.5 million. Could we get Phil Foden? The club is not impressed with our terms so far. If you're just going to, we need to up our offer. Oh, okay. No, I don't think they're willing to... Yeah, I don't... No, I don't want to make an offer for Phil Foden then. I think let's just go... Affection. If we go down... I mean, there's some people here. Lux is an Argentinian goalkeeper. 37 from River Plate. Interesting. I mean, there is a... slight change in the affection as we go a bit further down. I mean, who's that? They literally don't. Brazilians don't want to move to us. Okay. I mean, even all these players are so much better than what we've got. An 18-year-old on loan. I mean, would you be interested? They're not impressed with our offer in terms so far. Is it because they want us to buy him? Okay, I'm just going to leave that one as well. Let's go, and we'll come out. Actually, we'll come out of this. Now, this is going to be a bit of a makeshift episode. We will have a game in this episode. Not created. No renewal or free agents. Iron Robin. Yes, Iron Robin, come and join us. There's no way we can afford that salary, obviously. Do they have a weekly salary? So Guilherme does, but no one else does. Robin van Persie would be quite nice. Guilherme is the one that actually wants to move to us from Lokomotiv Moscow. I mean, all these players are so much better than what we've got. Flamini. I sort of feel like we need either someone that's going to score loads of goals or a very solid centre-back or central, or like holding midfielder. I think is what we want. Now, Pelessier, if I remember rightly, used to be absolutely rapid. He's 40 years old, so it's not going to be one for the future, but he's got good kicking power, good finishing, decent heading, good with his weaker foot. Where's his pace? Speed, 73, isn't too bad. yeah, it's going to be interesting. It's going to be very interesting, this, to make sure, you know, we get good people in that can help us out. So I'm just getting used to the buttons again. Boaz Myhill would be a much better goalkeeper as a free agent. He'll be much better than what we've already got. Tall as well, which would really help. Canas, Spanish playmaker in midfield, would be quite nice. Oh, Hooper. He was a goal scorer. Injury resistance 1. That's really, really bad. Perea, French winger. Not too bad. I think a striker. I think what we want, I think we do want a striker. Now, Gilias could be good. He's okay. 183. Figueroa. Manuel, it's not Manuel Figueroa. He used to play for Wigan. He's rapid. Good injury resistance. Not the tallest. Finishing 72 is a bit crap. Okay, let's go position. Sorry that this is a bit all over the place. Hopefully you're enjoying it, though. So we'll go out-and-out striker. And we'll go ability. So we want, ideally, we want... don't care what foot he is. I want finishing to be a minimum of... Let's see if there's anyone out there with 80. And we'll go for, see if we can get a goal scorer. 627 results are in here. So then we want... I want someone who's... Yeah, not... Who's got good injury resistance. So that's still 627. Then we want... At this level, stamina, because we want him to... Oh, I'll keep doing that. We want him to play nearly every game for us unless he gets injured. So let's go, 80 again. Okay, it hasn't changed from 627. So we could be in here. Let's try and put speed up there. Then we'll go for a speed merchant that can score. Again, we'll go 80 with that. Still says 627. So... Let's see. No, search result 0. There we go. It's just updated. I was going to say, I'd be massively surprised if there's someone like that in on a free agency. And if there are, then he's probably not going to move to us. Now, Robin Van Persie was on there, and I would love to get Robin Van Persie. We'll just put that down to 2 as well. 11 people. There we go. So we have 11 people that are centre forwards. Luis Adriano, ex Shakhtar Donetsk. Mark McNulty, ex Coventry. Owusu, Lopez, Mamiev, who actually played at the World Cup, if I remember rightly. Christian Lopez would be pretty decent as well. Fox in the box. Cochrane, who definitely has played at a World Cup. I used to love Cochrane when I was playing like on Football Manager and stuff. I used to absolutely love him. One touch pass and a first time shot, which is useful. I mean, look, he's got loads. He'd be really good to get. I just want to see if it's... Oh my god, man, you want so much money. I think I'm completely out of money. I mean, Stefan El Shaarawy would be an absolutely amazing signing, but I don't think that's going to happen. Let's look at Mark McNulty then. What would he want? Even he's too expensive. Jesus. He'll be given a more significant role. So we could afford Mark McNulty, which is 69, which isn't too much better, but we would be getting someone who has better stats in the area that we want. Now, good stamina, good finishing, obviously. Owusu wouldn't be too bad. 185, 187 Owusu as well. Christian Lopez. I think I'd like Christian Lopez. I think he would be decent. Mlapa would be good as well. Or Mamiev gives us a bit more utility. It really is more of an attacking midfielder, centre midfielder. But as a utility player, he might be useful to get. I mean, no, we're not getting him. Pretty much, I think it's Mark McNulty or Owusu. So this has been unsuccessful, looking for a striker. Let's lower something in here then. Let's get rid of... I could go for crosses and go for high balls in, but I don't like to play like that. Let's get rid of stamina, I guess. Let's just see. So 22, it gives us a little bit more. I just feel like we need other options. We really... Hugo Almeida... It's not Hugo Almeida, it can't be, he's Brazilian. Hugo Almeida. Freddy Friday. I've signed him before on Football Manager. Stokers Gilhas is there again. Who is in and around the sort of weaker players? Fortune. Abono Plata is new in there as well. 29, so we'll get a few more years out of him, which could be good. 172, not very tall. 177. Now, this guy could be quite useful. I mean, Freddy Friday, he's got an amazing name and he's only 24. First time shot, long range drive. He's still technically progressing up. Out and out striker. 9,000. Oh, man. I mean, we can lower your release fee. If someone wants to give us, like, 10,000 for you, I'll take that. We'll give you appearance bonuses, we'll give you goal bonuses, and we'll give you that. And we still are just, it's too much salary, Freddy. Too much salary. This guy from Congo, 20 years old, tall, tracks back, and that's not the best for a striker. I mean, he's 20 years old, surely we can get him. Oh man, we'd be just over the budget. Again, if you want to do that, I'm gonna, yeah, I know we don't have the funds, but I'm gonna make the offer. I'm gonna go in there. I would like to try and get someone on loan. Maybe if we just go, let's have a look. See who's transfer listed. Because we've got a big transfer budget. Gabriel Jesus is transfer listed as well. I think we're gonna need to go. In fact, probably what we need to do is let's go and have a look and say. Someone like Derby. Who's transfer listed from Derby? Because they're a bigger team than us. So yeah, Bird, not the best, but 19, holding midfielder, could be a bit more solid than what we've got, but nothing amazing. Maybe we go lower Premiership. Who have Brighton got transfer listed? So six people were transfer listed from Brighton as well. Button in goal would be quite useful, or Steel. Steel's a bit lower rated, so let's try and get him on the loan. We can pay you. There aren't anything such an offer. I mean, I'm just going to go with like this. Because I don't know if we get him and they just pay his wages. I'm not too sure. So we'll make the offer. See how that goes. And I guess let's go into our first game. Have we got scouts? I want no preference but to focus on still developing players, and I don't really mind let's go South America, obviously. Budget, yeah, consider the budget, and yeah, go and have a look at that. Oh, we've got, yeah, we can use all three scouts. Okay, so enable you, we'll get you to go just for a centre forward. We'll go for you to get a centre back from, well, I don't really care where, and we want a overall rating and consider the budget, and then you, will enable you as well, and we'll go midfielders. Don't mind. No, I want a central midfielder. Let's get a. Let's go Europe. Again, we want someone that's pretty much already ready to come in and do the job. So we'll see. Seeing what our scouts can find. Let's get into it then. We're going to go forward in time. And I think we've got our first game coming up. I'm not too sure. No, we're still in the transfer window. So let's see what happens. I'm going to have a quick drink of lemonade. Okay, so Jason Steele has gone horrendously wrong, which is fine. That's okay. So other negotiations with. Okay, so he wants Wamangituka. I don't know why I've gone for someone whose name I can't pronounce. So Jason Steele have broken out. He didn't see a future at our club. That's okay. Let's renegotiate with you. And oh, I can get you in budget. If you're not satisfied by the terms that we propose, let me know your preference. I reckon we try and get him down like this, and then we'll give him. I'll tell you what, if you score goals, you can have £1,500 for every goal you score, which is quite a lot, but I'm hoping that then brings him round and it actually then give us space to get another person in. So he's asking for better terms, so he'll probably reject that, I imagine. But let's wait and see, shall we? I mean, this could be a transfer episode, to be honest. It could just be us getting used to the Master League. Because if you're a big team, if you do like Man United, I think you get the ICC Cup again. Perisic has hit his stride for Bayern, which is good. Negotiations. Other teams. And, oh, has he? I think he's accepted it. He's demanding a low contract release fee. Okay, let's just have a quick... What's he asked for? Release fee. That's all right. It's near his market value. I'm happy with that. If they give us a... is that 11 million? Yeah, 11 million. Yeah. Brilliant. Okay, first person is in. Yes, we have £810 left of our weekly wage. But we've got a striker, which is good, which is what I wanted. So he'll be joining up with us pretty soon. He's accepted our offer. All we need to do is sign off on the deal, and he's one of us. So that's good. We've got a new striker in who's going to be banging in goals, and it's a guy who I can't pronounce. So awesome work, Dave. Brilliantly well done that you've signed someone whose name you can't pronounce. But it doesn't matter if I can pronounce it. Roberto Carlos has got to be able to announce it, hasn't he? That's the issue. That's the thing. And here we go. There he is. He's turned up at the training ground, getting a chat by... Again, we need names. We need names for the chief exec or the chairman, whatever we would think he is going to be, on the left, the bald guy who isn't Roberto Carlos. And then we need the guy who clearly doesn't say anything but just follows him around. And there we go. What a lovely picture that is for Roberto Carlos, his new signing. And he's got the ball. I'm still in my suit. Oh, no, I'm not in a suit. I'm in a tracksuit now, which is actually quite nice. I don't mind that. It's pretty good, and there he is. Hello, my name is S. Wamangituka. I wanted to say thank you to the Wigan Athletic Sports for welcoming me, and I missed the rest of it. See you at the stadium. Yeah, boy. See you at the stadium. There we go. Well done. Welcome to the club, my man. We've got him in. I'm very much looking forward to seeing him in action. I really am. Right. Negotiations. Scouting. Okay, you found Douglas Baggio. What a name that is. I want to sign you just for your name. Douglas Baggio. That's an incredible name. I mean, there's a high chance of success. So, okay, we'll just pay you the minimum to have you on loan. Douglas Baggio. We do also just need players in the door, to be honest, because obviously we don't have that many. Yeah, you guys haven't found anyone else yet. I love the fact that my scout like flew to South America and was just like, he landed and was just like, yep, yeah, you're really good, you're really good, you're really good. Yep, yeah, I'll send that back. So we've got an offer for Vasil, who is one of our starting centre-backs. I'm going to reject that because that's a rubbish offer. I think that's the only one. Yeah. So, oh, manager's office, messages. This is going to be... I think I meant to look at messages before I do anything else, but I never do. Right, team management, skill training. I imagine I won't have anyone. Oh, Arcas can do the double touch. Okay, hold RS up or down and then left. Okay, Arcas comes with a crossover turn. Okay, Arcas is quite skillful. I like that. Scotch move, and then that. We have Mihail of heading. Yes. I do like a header of the ball. He is a target man, and he does look nice in the Wigan kit, and he is 184 centimetres tall. So, yes, you can do that. Have we got anyone else that does anything down here? No. Okay, so we don't have anyone that does anything like that. So I'm wondering, we might as well get Arcas to do one of these. Crossover turns the easiest, so... oh, no, okay, so you're going to do one at a time. Balls, forgot about that. Do I want to do training in here? No, I'm just going to leave that as it is. Team management, game plan. Let's get our new striker in. I didn't see all these people down here. Just, oh, bloody hell, okay. Right, so Gios is off and Wamangituka is going to come in. And then, actually, we're going to have Arcas replace him out there. And Arcas is going to go to a second striker role on the left. Carlson can come on the bench ahead of Driessen. Then we do... Okay, so we could potentially sell a striker. Might try and sell Hervey, I think. We'll leave it like that. That is the only change I'm going to really do. Palace, there is a bit of weak on that side, 63. Okay. 50. Hey, that's not very good, is it? That's not very good for team spirit, but that's always the case. That's why it's so hard to do it. But yeah, okay. No, let's go team management, negotiations, my team. Let's see if we can sell one of these strikers. Yeah, Jarvis, there you are. Let's transfer policy. We are open to offers. We are open to reasonable offers, and we'll put you on the transfer list. Job done. I also think let's put our backup. Didn't want to do that. No, don't want to renew his contract either. Come on, Dave, you're having a nightmare here. Mayer, remove from listed players. Mayer, transfer policy. Done. Right. Because I reckon we can call up a young goalkeeper who's probably better than him in our youth team. But let's forward in time and see how this gets on. It's a bit more like a stream. I mean, we've been going for half an hour already, so I do apologise. This is going to be a long episode. Juventus have signed Coutinho from Bayern Munich after he's just moved to Bayern Munich. PES, don't ever change. That's amazing. Messages. Okay, so we've got a deal for Douglas Baggio, and we brought him in purely because of his name, which is amazing. Yeah, so we don't pay his wages, or are we going to pay £360 a week? His loan club will pay his salary. That's fine. It's another body in the door. Let's go and get back to the loan market. This is purely going to be just a transfer episode, it looks like. Next episode will be the first game of the season. Apologies about that. I want to quickly look in the youth team again. Do we have a goalkeeper? We don't have a goalkeeper that's better, but we do have one that's only one rating worse and probably has a lot more growth than our other goalkeeper. Our other goalkeeper, I imagine. Right, let's go advanced search. Loan list. We'll go South America, Brazil. Let's see what young Brazilians we can get in. So we're looking around this sort of mark. So Hulk is always a cracking name. Malafaia, Igor Jesus, Igor Vinicius, Romarinho. What name that is? Paulo Miranda. You are listed for loan, my friend. And we can afford your loan fee. Hopefully, you're interested to move to us. I mean, most of these are interested to move to us, which is very nice. Enzo as a goalkeeper would probably be better. Martinelli from Arsenal. Yes, please. Oh, man, it's all of our budget. No, I think they just don't want to send him on loan to us, which is more than understandable. Nicholas from Udinese, I doubt we'll get him. We're probably getting into the territory where they won't move to us, so he's obviously just moved. A goalkeeper would be very nice. Ronaldo, let's get a Ronaldo. Surely I've got to try and get a Ronaldo in. Surely. Roberto Carlos and Ronaldo linking up again. That'd be amazing. But they're not impressed with any offer, so they probably won't accept it. Kanu at the back, even that would be epic. Can't sign people just for name, Dave. I should be looking into the way they fit our team as well. Perotti, 60. I don't need another striker. There is a goalkeeper I need, annoyingly. Why can't I loan you? That's very annoying. You're on the loan list. Let's see if... did we look at Nicholas? The club is not impressed with our offer. I mean, let's just offer something anyway. We need a goalkeeper, and Udinese's backup will be better than nobody. Klaus. Again, he's probably going to be better than what we've got. It's a lot. It's a fair whack of money. We'll have a look. Just see if they entertain it. It says they're not going to, but we'll have a look. I I'd love to have a Ronaldo in the team. Vinicius Tanque is a great name. Wenderson as well. Vico on power. Lidio. You've got to remember, because we're going to be watching these players. We have no idea who these players are. So we're going to be sort of playing this game together, watching these guys and seeing how they get on. And I do think that coming up soon is the game against Cardiff City. So we'll hopefully get these transfers done. Is this deadline day? No, national squad announcements. So Douglas Baggio joins up. We've got messages as well. National team newcomer notice. Negotiations with Varane. We've seen off Varane from Charlton Athletic. They're hoping we sell him on the cheap now that he's past his prime. I don't think so. So let's have a look into other teams. Are you joking me? Oh, we're currently in negotiations. It will take several days before we have an answer. So they're in negotiations and Douglas Baggio has joined. Okay, so it's just saying. I thought it was like they've accepted those offers. I was going to go, fucking hell, get in. That'd be incredible. Varane 67. Oh, see, you've got to... I'll negotiate with you because you've got to give me loads of money. You cannot raise your salary higher than the player's release fee. Okay, so I'm going to assume that's a release fee. But have you got anybody that wants to move to us? Okay, Kale could be useful. And, the problem is to let him go in part exchange. Okay, take that off. Well, what's his release fee then? 1.15. They're probably. I mean, who else have they got? I mean, Johnny Williams would be good, but they're probably not going to let him. Yeah. Didn't think they'd let him go either. Apparently he's old. Zuma would be quite good to get in. Leko would be very good to get in. We don't need a right midfielder. Okay, we'll just get them to pay his release fee, I think. We'll close that off. And yeah, you just pay the release fee. And if you want him, that's what you got to pay. I think that's a fair way to do it. I think, and we'll push on forwards again. But so far, I've been impressed by the Master League. Other than Coutinho, you know, leaving Bayern when he's just moved to them. That's a bit stupid, but yeah, I'm impressed with it. But we're going to leave this episode right here, and we're going to be back for the league opener, and we'll come back with this press conference in the next episode. But thank you so much for watching. For now, I'm out. Cheers.